guys, we're work in progress, and this is part two of our Dungeons and Decaf, right?
Yeah!
Okay, our Dungeons and Decaf series. So, to start off the show, we're going to do a short form for you called Two Princes. What I'm going to need is a brave volunteer from the audience. Could I get... Okay.
Here we go.
Okay. So, Alan, whether you like it or not, you're about to be wooed by two members of Work in Progress. Well, we'll find out. How this is going to work is two members of Work in Progress will come down. They will get three tries to woo you based on aspects of your character. And at the end, you get to decide who is... We got two guys, so who's your man?
Who's your man?
Who's your man?
After you. Oh, Balin, oh, Balin. Your hair is like...
Cheetos.
Oh, shit.
Pigeons.
Like
the golden sun.
Your hair is like pigeons. Always there, but, you know, sometimes it fits me off.
Balin. Sweet Balin. Your forehead is like a...
Billboard.
Is like a billboard. It calls to me and just wants to make me look at you.
Balin. Oh, adorable Balin. Your muscles are like...
A mailbox.
Potatoes. Your muscles are like potatoes. Everyone says they're average, but believe me, they're great.
Valen, oh Valen, your compassion is like a...
Broccoli.
It's like a ticking time bomb. It's, right now everything seems totally fine, but I'll be gone at the end.
Valen, your eyes are like...
Two ants. Arrows!
Your eyes are like two ants. Small, but their impact, enormous.
Valen. Sexy, sexy Valen. Your ears are like a... Your ears are like a crazed wolf. Unrelenting.
Who's it gonna be? Connor? Or Hector?
I believe my man is going to be Hector.
Yes! No! Alright, unless you want!
No! Now that you've seen that it's possible to find love at an improv show, who else wants to try this? Alright, could you give the crowd your name?
Varun.
Alright.
You say it one more time?
Varun, V-A-R-U-N.
Varun?
N.
Varun.
Yes, got it.
Varun. Sweet, sweet Varun. Your eyes are like...
That waffles!
Back. I'm really
your
crackers.
Eyes are like waffles. Despite pouring syrup in them, they make my heart filled with cholesterol.
Varun. Oh, Varun. Your ears are like...
Two rubies!
I'm a rupee.
Of course! Because they are the most perfect and most voluminous of all ears.
Varun. Strong, strong Varun. Your eyebrows are like...
Caterpillars! Cats on dogs!
I heard cats on dogs. Defying nature in their gloriousness.
Oh, Varun, I must tell you, your beard is like...
The Stone Age!
A stick of butter. I just want to rub it all over me.
Varun, your kneecaps, they remind me of
Jones.
They try to sell me insurance, I think. Or travel plans.
Travel plans.
Oh, Varn. I must tell you, your right shoulder reminds me of
his tiny friend's
left shoulder. So even, so strong.
All right. They both made a compelling case, but there can only be one for you. Who's it gonna be?
And they won't be able to say any sentence. The only thing they can speak is in questions to each other. So if they answer one of each other's questions, they're out. So what I need is a suggestion, maybe some question that you have and that you don't want to see answered on stage.
What did the teapot bring?
How do you get me out of love therapy?
Out of love therapy. Cool. And can we have a location too?
Oh, an allocation? Where love therapy is?
Amusement park!
The restaurant!
Desk office in Hitler!
The moon!
McDonald's!
Run down!
McDonald's.
How do you get me out of love therapy?
Are we in love therapy right now?
Don't you know that love therapy always happens in a McDonald's? Are you gonna eat that double cheeseburger? Did you supersize this?
No, I saw the movie.
Are you here to meet hot, sexy singles at McDonald's? Are you my love therapist? Are you into bad morals and ethics in your therapist?
Didn't you see that I was eating a double cheeseburger?
Didn't you know I like cholesterol in my victims? I mean...
Well, did you just say victims?
Yes!
Are you my love therapist?
You gonna end up magically on Tinder?
Yep.
What can I get for you today, sir? Do you know where you are right now?
Can I get it with no pickles?
Can you leave and go to a Burger King?
On this counter.
Can you leave, sir?
Can you just close the window on me?
Have you left yet?
Have you left yet?
Do you not see me through the glass?
Did you get your Whopper?
Would you believe they didn't sell Whoppers?
Do you want to sue?
Are we able to sue because they don't have that food?
Why not?
I feel like that's not right.
Have you seen my parents?
Where's the last place you saw them?
Where is the bathroom?
Have you tried in the back?
Have you seen the old guy right there?
Are you talking about my husband?
Is your husband that ugly?
Is he gonna have a problem?
I don't have a problem.
Do you even know where my parents are?
Why are you asking me, kid?
I don't know!
Have you seen my child? The child's come from the back. Is that where he is? Where was the last place you saw him? Am I supposed to know that? Are you a new parent? Am I a bad mom? Are you putting words in my mouth? Oh, is that what you're saying right now? Do you want me to help you find them? Can you? Will you let me? Yes, please!
Don Stubble, FBI, have you seen this mom and this child?
Are they in trouble?
Would you believe it if I said they're wanted in 25 counties of three states?
Are the 25 counties in the same three states?
Can you help me out? I can't read maps.
Why are you a cop if you can't read maps?
Didn't you know that there's a non-geographical department in the FBI?
Why would I need to know that?
Aren't you my partner I was supposed to meet here?
Why are you
So, are you my partner?
How much more obvious do you need to be?
Could you show me your badge?
Are you looking down here?
Don't you know I'm paralyzed from this part of
my head? Are you gonna make me do this?
Could you lift your arm up to about here?
Can we go somewhere more private?
Don't you know my feet are also paralyzed?
What am I gonna do with you?
Could you push me to a secret location so you can show me your badge?
No.
No, I can't.
No, comrade, are you super secret Spetsnaz officer in McDonald's?
Please, could you turn me so I could see you?
Why do you need me to turn your head?
Can you read this medical report? It explains everything.
Is this in English?
Can you read English?
Is it similar to Russian?
Sometimes.
Have you seen any commies around here?
Let me bend. What do you mean by a commie?
Have you ever looked in the eyes of someone and seen complete defeat?
Is it similar to looking into the eyes of the gulag?
Have you thought, comrade?
What was that? Sorry?
Have you thought, comrade?
What is thought?
Are you who I think you are?
That depends. Who am I?
Are you the man who is Putin's personal wiggle instructor?
How do you know that Putin has a wiggle instructor?
Would you believe that our intel says he does?
What kind of intel are you talking about?
How do you know about this intel?
Don't you know us Russians? I mean, we people have satellites.
What do you mean, we people?
I'm gonna go check on that.
Would you like fries with that?
Are you a commie?
What's a commie?
Are you in favor of sharing fries with everyone, regardless of class?
You know I make $10 an hour.
Are you feeling the urge to seize the means of production?
Would that involve overthrowing the bourgeoisie of McDonald's?
Yes!
Won't you please go get me my coat? I seem to have left it open.
Do you hear the people sing?
Does anyone have my order? Have you ever been murdered with a spatula before? Have you ever cleaned yourself? Have you ever had a spatula shoved through your chest area? Oh, have I ever?
Would you like fries with that?
No. No.
Oh my God, you big strong boy. Did you really kill him?
Did you hear the people sing?
Was that because of you?
Yes.
Do you know the rules of prison, bud?
Does it look like I've been to prison before?
Don't you see who I am right here?
Can you explain the tattoo on your neck?
Do I need to start the story?
Would you?
Do you want to hear this story?
Did I not just ask you to do that?
How many times have you seen perturbating things in your life?
Never.
Do you think I should go with the blue or the red?
Why do you keep asking me this shit?
We're getting married, right?
Really?
Really?
What are you doing in my McDonald's?
Who said it was your McDonald's?
know it's my turf?
Do you even know how to read signs?
Do you know that just because my name's not on there, it doesn't mean it's not my turf?
Ooh. Yes, Pushnik.
Do you want me to do it again?
Would you do it? You wanna fight?
Does it look like I wanna dance?
Yes!
Alrighty! Hello! Welcome, everybody, young and old.
Mostly young.
Mostly young.
Mostly young. To Josh jumping over a wall. Today we are going to be embarking on our second episode of Critical Roast, where our party of four adventurers embark on a dangerous journey to save their world from impending doom. So, we're going to go through real quickly and just introduce our characters, and then I'll explain how the game works one more time real quick, and then we'll get right into it.
Hi, I'm Eldon. I'm a dwarf plumber, and I carry a monkey wrench and hit people with it real good. I like to drink. If you're looking for me, find me at the pub.
I'm Run. I'm the centaur, father of 20 little centaurs and one satyr. I'm here to find the promised land where I will keep my children safe, and I fight by kicking.
Hi, I'm Mag. I'm the elf clown. I like to juggle, and my weapons are the various things that I juggle, which include bowling balls, bowling pins, fruit, and occasionally chainsaws, which were taken from me last round. I wish people would take me seriously, but hopefully one day I'll be a ringleader.
Hello, my name is SmokeyBot 5000. I go by Smokey. I was once an animatronic bear meant to stop children from starting forest fires. By tragic fate, someone attached a flamethrower to my wrist. I am no longer part of the band. I seek one day to find a forest that is not flammable.
Awesome. And so, just a reminder of the way the game works. Just like D&D, we're going to be rolling dice to determine how they do with certain actions that they do. But instead of using a complicated D20, we're going to be using a D4 and a special format. So the way it works is a 4 is an epic success. They succeeded with flying colors. A 3, they succeeded, you know, good job. 2, they failed, but you know, it wasn't as bad as they possibly could be. And a 1, an epic failure. Whatever they tried backfired, possibly. Or they die. But either way, that's how it's gonna happen. These guys are gonna do a scene for us, D&D themed, and periodically I might ask you guys for suggestions on, you know, be like, I'll do this, and you guys, you know, suggestions. Just like improv. So, can I get a suggestion for a general suggestion, anything?
What's wrong?
Finding the kid.
What's wrong?
Dumbledore!
Giant Republican and big one beard!
What's that, Adrian?
Adrian? What was that?
I said one beard.
One beard? One beard?
Yes. I don't know why you picked me. That's my worst one.
Rolling with that!
One beard.
I'm ready for the strongest beard theme of the night. Awesome. Okay. We find ourselves.
Wait, hold on, we're gonna do a recap.
Yeah, that's what we're doing. That's what we're doing right now. We're zooming in. We find ourselves early on. The world is slowly colliding with the sun, and the Galaga machine winks with the robot.
It's not a
later, Dave and Buster comes up, bringing them a quest.
I'm Dave and Buster, and I have a quest.
Then, he brings up his dark wizard, who owns Chuck E. Cheese, a.k.a. Chuck E. Cheese.
My brother, Chuck E. Cheese, is trying to make the world and the sun collide, and he's using that power to make the machines evil.
So they head to Chuck E. Cheese's, not before confronting a large bodyguard holding a giant sword.
I hope I don't kill you.
He rolled a 4 and killed him. They go inside Chuck E. Cheese's, where they meet a live, demon-like creature offering them a game of chance.
You wanna play skee-ball?
Okay.
After several attempts of playing skee-ball, failing, breaking
Welcome
windows,
to Cindy and skee-ball.
The Chuck E. Cheese's blows up, but not before sneakily getting the briefcase. Children, fire, and explosions happen everywhere.
Not again.
our dwarf hits the head off of the after running away, screaming into the woods. Later, they open the briefcase, discovering a small magical item in the shape of a pole that talks.
A pole that talks.
And as he answers questions, he gets smaller and smaller, eventually fading out of existence.
Although he's answering our questions ambiguously and shrinking at the same time.
He gives them three locations.
You gotta go to the magic forest, the troll of the Bridge of a Thousand Trolls, and then Eagle Mountain. Bye.
Oh no.
And that is where we left off.
Okay, I didn't want to call that.
I'm sorry.
Found a chair. I'm sorry.
After sleeping a long night contemplating the events previously, decapitating people, strange locations. They wake up to start planning their day.
I need a drink.
You want an apple instead?
No.
I'll take an apple. I'm tired of standing up while sleeping and lie down with four legs.
You want me to push you down next time?
That'd be cool. Can you like tip me over?
I've tipped cows before. I don't know why I said it'd be so hard.
All right, we can try that.
Look. Beating around the bush here. We got a mission.
The magical forest.
Yeah.
Well, I don't have a map.
I think I have Google Maps.
You only have one. He's using Internet Explorer.
Damn
it'll
it.
Take like 3 years.
2%.
In Centaur School, we learn to guide us by the stars. So. Get this out of my bag, all right? I'll trace down the hypotenuse from the North Pole towards
the floor. Miraculously, even though it's morning, he can still track the stars.
Every damn star in the morning.
I guess you really only need the one, huh?
All right, this is where we're gonna go. So here's like a triangle. We gotta go right into east. So, right there.
That way.
Yeah, yeah.
You don't have to tell me twice.
Right, so it would be like 10 miles down the road, and we will find the entrance to the magic forest.
And so our adventurers trot down the path. Not but an hour later do they find themselves at the entrance of the magical forest. Two distinct doorways lie before them, with one guard.
Are you on the list?
They rolled a 4. They're on the list.
Which door?
Suddenly, the first door shuts and the second door opens. It appears that the party has been split.
Yeah, so they were on the list. You guys are not on the list. I'm sorry.
What do you mean we're not?
What do you mean we're not on the list?
The list. See their names.
We'll go around. Well, I'm sure that there's a way out at the end, and we'll meet
up. No. I want to see that door open, and I want to go through.
He rolled a 3 on persuasion. He's willing to let them go through the other door, but not that door.
All right, look. Just because my manager's not around, I can let you through the other door. I don't know where it goes, but I can let you through it.
Can you send a message through to our friends in the other side, and then the two of us will go in this door?
He rolled a 4. He has them on speed dial.
Can you tell them I have a flare, and when they make it out, send up the flare?
Hello.
Hey,
who is this? Is this that telemarketer again?
All right. That's my day job. This is my night job.
Okay. Why are you calling me telemarketer off hours?
So your elfin friend,
Mag.
Okay, yeah, Mag.
He's Mag. Enron?
Enron?
Are you
Enron?
Enron. Yeah.
Okay.
Enron is alive.
So
give them this flare to send up when they get out of the woods.
I don't think I can send a flare through the phone.
That's why
I heard flare.
You rolled a 4, and the phone can take flare.
Actually, it looks like I have Uber flare. Let me just.
Ow! It's a flare.
You got it.
All right.
I'll hold on to this.
Tell them to send it up when they're out.
Yeah, can you send it up?
Sure. Can you? Just don't send them through the phone too.
Does he mean now?
No, not now. Not.
When did you want it?
When they're out.
Okay, yeah, when you're out, when you're out.
When we are out.
Oh, out.
Out.
And but so the party splits now, entering the forest in two different locations, seemingly, an incredibly dense forest. We find ourselves with the first group, the robot Smokey 5000 and Eldin the dwarf. When not but 5 minutes walking through the forest, they find a strange man wearing nothing but a white mask and hip-hop clothes dancing next to a beatboxer.
Danger, Eldin.
Hey, wiggity wiggity kids, how's it going?
Well,
I'm Donald Dorgan, and welcome to my beatbox club. You gotta outdance me to get to the dance hall.
I don't trust this man's eyebrows.
Sure enough, his eyebrows curl up and connect with his head hair. It's very strange.
The only dance I know is, ironically, the robot.
But that's you. That's really you. You go out there and you give it everything you've got.
I'm afraid to go loose with the flamethrower.
I don't know this guy. I feel fine if you burn him to a crisp.
If you say so.
Did he just say burn us to a crisp?
I don't think so.
My boy's in the circle!
Hey, before we do this, I want to make sure that you know that this is high stakes dancing. Disco dancing, beatbox club, dance hall dancing club. So!
There are too many genres.
Oh yeah! So, I'll put up this fine magical item that I've been carrying for a long time if you put up something of equal value. And the winner takes it all.
I don't own anything as I am a robot, but my friend has many children.
The beatboxer pulls out what appears to be a broom that somehow vibrates with strange magical energy.
It's a vibrating broom.
It only vibrates with magical energy.
Oh, no, it was a witch's a long time ago.
He knows it as the broom of sweeping.
It's a broom of sweeping.
Oh, okay.
Get your mind out of the gutter. What?
I think we should go double or nothing since there's two of them.
Okay. Double or nothing.
So we'll put up this other magical item.
Yeah.
His friend pulls out a golden amulet, a locket. And as he opens it up, it starts singing wildly.
Your mom gave you that!
For it is an amulet of singing.
I think you'll win, I trust you.
All right. I do have arthritis real bad, but we'll figure it out. What do they have?
Do we have a second thing to offer?
I just found it.
Oh, and as he looks under a rock, he rolls a 2, so it's not gonna be great. But their pants that never fit anyone.
They sag just enough for us.
Right. Yeah. I need a wardrobe update. Okay.
Acceptable terms.
Honestly, I just really like to dance, so like I don't care. Yeah. It'll be fun.
And so lights drop from the ceiling. A disco ball, lasers, smoke everywhere. Enough for a dance party. Sure.
We need to use the amulet to kind of.
Yeah.
What track is this?
It's just the amulet wants to sing.
The beatboxer rolls a 3 and does a pretty good jig.
Your pelvic thrusts mean nothing to me if there's nothing attached.
The robot unfortunately rolls a 1 and his flamethrower starts sputtering. Not yet throwing flame, but a precursor to something terrible.
Not right now. Righty, no! Righty, don't!
And then all of a sudden, a gout of flame incinerating the person in front of them. It rolls a 3. He's on fire. He's not dead yet, but he's on fire.
Oh! I burn it up! I want to do the worm!
I use the broom.
Okay!
He rolls a 1. The broom, like, catches on fire. Now it's a fire broom of sweeping. I'm really hurting him more.
I'm bad at the worm!
I'm just going to put him out of his misery.
In attempting to put him out of his misery with a wrench, he rolls a one and kills him.
But wait! His body comes back ethereal. No. Angelic.
He has ascended to the next plane of existence, a higher being.
He just killed my brother. I mean, he's still here, but you technically
You've
killed him.
You've done it!
Service. Ron Jr. hasn't called.
Are there 17 other Ron Jr.?
No.
What are you?
A creature approaches them. It
Excuse
has
me?
Six legs and a bucket for a hat.
Whoa.
Hello. What are you doing here? This is my part of the town. Oh, so sorry. Didn't mean to intrude. We're trying to get out. You have, like, instructions or a map or any way that we can get out of here?
The creature rolls a two. It's willing to share, but only for a price.
Well?
Say your terms.
I've been living here for a while. All right.
Yeah. You need friends?
Spinner.
Nice to meet you.
Ron, nice to meet you.
Matt.
My home, yes.
Very lovely home, yes.
Yeah.
So I can help you. Okay.
But, it'll be for a price.
What price?
You got any magical items on you?
I'm gonna check my bag right here.
Yeah.
Rolling a three, he opens his bag, pulling out from it a pretty decent magical item.
It's a pretty decent magical item, as you can see right here. Yeah.
He pulls out a manual that says sensitivity training in a corporate environment. A very powerful magic item.
It's very useful.
We've been trying to get a promotion. Map first.
That's true, map first. Otherwise, no promotion for you.
Other hand. Now this map is dangerous. Mm. You're not worthy? You'll be trapped here, grow extra legs, and live without promotions for life. So, you know, here you go.
Oh, God, is that what happened to you?
I'll see you.
All right. I don't trust this.
I don't trust it either. I'm a little concerned you just took it.
Ron the centaur rolls a four on insight. He is wise not to trust the spider, for she spins not just webs, but lies.
I can see the lies spinning out of her arms. Full of lies, man.
You want me to throw something at her? What do you want me to do?
I don't know. You open this. We gave you a map. We gave you the manual.
It can only be opened once. So if I open it, then we just can't close it.
Bad point.
Okay.
Opening up, sure enough, a poison dagger comes flying out and impales the spider, not killing it, rolling a three, in its forehead.
I'll get the map. Wait.
Is it actually a map, though? Hold on.
Okay, let's
go.
Upon closer inspection, it is a map. But it's a special map.
It's a special map.
On the map, there are several X's dotting the path ahead. What could they be? Probably something great. Who knows?
I'm gonna pull up the dagger.
Go! Dead!
I'm saving you. Do you know how to read the map? Now you have nothing stuck in your brain, so you can read the map.
There's a hole in my brain now, and I can't.
God damn it, she's useless.
You wanna kick her to death? I'm holding the map, I can't throw nothing.
Alright,
I'll
take it to there. No, no! He rolls a 4 and she splatters into a million. but not before dropping a few interesting things. Off her head flies a strange, sickly looking hat. A beret, in fact, that is very sticky. In fact, because it is made out of web. They have, in their possession, a sticky beret. A very sticky beret. Also, they find a backpack. Inside the backpack, it jingles a bit. What could be inside? Upon opening it up, two shiny gauntlets, chrome, glistening in the sunlight. Upon donning these gauntlets, the wearer has an intense urge to high-five people. These are the gauntlets of high-fives!
Yes! I need to give you a high-five.
Hold on, I got the map!
No, drop them up! One hand, fine!
his thirst for high fives are sated for now, but they will come back.
I'm sorry, that was weird.
No, it's all right. So, now we have a couple problems. Of A, we have a map that we don't know how to read. And B, I can't close it.
Man, let me see if the ancient knowledge of the centaurs comes back to my mind. And I can get some tree roots right here.
He rolls a 2. They only know how to read stars, not maps.
My ancestor says there's no luck with maps.
All of a sudden, a flare in the sky.
Oh, they made it out!
We cut to the other part of the party.
Why did you fire the flare? We are still stuck!
I was dying to see what it looked like. Beautiful.
Upon the sight of the flare, attracting many creatures, a strange ape-like creature jumps out of the canopy. He rolls a 3, knocking it unconscious. Not dead, unconscious.
Oh my god.
Then another, out of the tree again, another strange ape-like creature.
Hey! What's up?
He rolls a 1. His wrench goes careening off. And out of, and into the trees.
No! Don't try that shit on me! Well, I'm a ninja monkey!
The other ape wakes up from his stupor, from being hit in the head.
Fuck!
you surprised me in a very startling way.
Yeah, well, you fired a freaking thing when I was sleeping.
Well, be diurnal then. Don't sleep all day.
What does that mean?
It's the opposite of nocturnal.
Ah,
oh.
Really?
Really? It's a real. Is it just four? He rolled a 4.
He rolled a 4. It like inspires everyone. Right?
See, knowledge is power.
What we don't know is how to leave these woods.
Yeah. Well, you guys set up a flare, and we're ninja monkeys. And
yeah, I'm kind of against helping the guy just smack me in the head.
Come on, don't be such a meanie, Larry.
I tried to hit him too,
but I wasn't a pussy.
The monkey rolled a 2. That comment struck a chord, and now there seems to be a tension between the two ninja apes.
You know what, Jack? At least I can get a girlfriend.
Yeah, but have you seen your girlfriend? She's disgusting.
The party slowly backs away, only the 4 completely stealthing out of there as the two monkeys argue. Later down the path, they find right in the middle of the path a large red X.
Wait. It could be a sign.
It could be... I don't know.
Take 1 step further.
A voice.
That sounds trustworthy.
My peer pressure level.
All of a sudden, the X turns into a pit, and the dwarf falls through. Down and down he goes, perpetually falling, the hole at the top getting smaller and smaller.
Are you perpetually
sudden he slows down. And then he goes the other way back up.
There's a trampoline at the bottom.
It's just a really deep hole with a trampoline. That was terrifying.
Who would do this?
Oh. I saw my whole life flash before my eyes.
Yeah. It's a pool of enlightenment.
Such a rush from that.
Okay, you know what? I did think it sounded rather trustworthy, but now I need to speak to you. Hello, tree people!
Yeah? What do you want?
Okay, I could have assumed there was more than one.
Yeah, well, you said people, so...
Here we are.
Does one of you speak for the rest?
I speak for the poplars. She speaks for the elms.
Things seem really divisive in this forest.
I'm a maple.
We cut to the other party.
After walking down the path for several more minutes, they approach one of the strange exes on the map.
I'm just saying, she's like overweight and gross and like she's covered in bugs and shit.
Yeah, but we have a special connection now.
The party notices a strange pair of apes dressed in ninja garb arguing over someone.
Can we help you guys?
Yeah, yeah.
Please?
Can you guys read the map? There are like multiple X's.
He's a cartographer.
He rolled a one, he's a really shitty cartographer.
There's a couple X's, go to them.
Oh no shit, you freaking ape.
Wait, hold on.
Which people today?
Have you seen some other people walking around? The robot and the little guy? Have you seen anybody like that in these woods?
Yeah, one of them hit Larry with a wrench. Larry was being a pussy, and then...
Are we going back to that?
Yes, we are, because your girlfriend is...
Okay.
Wait.
Where were they? Like, where do you see them? Where did they hit?
You guys see the flare?
Yeah, we saw it.
Yeah, there.
The flare, yeah. They set up a flare.
But there's not, like, a wall, so, like, we can jump from, like, path A to path B just fine.
We were literally there, like, 5 minutes ago, just about. We just been arguing here.
There's not even a path. It's literally just a horse.
We just trudge.
You guys know the way out of the forest, because we're trying to reach.
They roll the three. They do it all the way.
We do. Here, jump down that hole. There's trampolines at the bottom of all of them, and they're, like, really fun.
Wait. No, some of them aren't trampolines.
Right.
Wait, what?
There's some that have spikes.
The nature spirits are dickheads here.
There's no spikes at the bottom of this one.
I'm a maple.
What do we do? I don't trust these guys. I don't trust the freaking trees talking to me.
All of a sudden, a massive creature jumps out of the tree canopy, crushing the two apes under its massive feet. It stands up, covered in spiky protrusions, leathery skin, and two giant wings.
Hi.
And a chicken.
Hi. Hello.
How's it going?
Good.
It immediately starts eating the bodies of the apes underneath. The party gathers. This is a hostile.
Alright, I think we need to kill this thing before he
eats. I'd rather run. You're fast, four legs.
Alright, just copy my bag and we'll run out of
the
creature.
Wow, they roll a four and they get away with it. We cut to the other part of the party. Before them, they see a large sign that says exit. And directly next to it, another sign pointing in the opposite direction saying exit. It is a conundrum.
Well, which one is it?
It's a bad breakout case.
Use your intuitive deductive reasoning. Or Google Maps, see if you get any service.
It's at 5% still. Here, I'll try burning one of them.
Only the real exit sign won't catch on fire.
He rolls a one, they both catch on fire.
That did not work.
Alright, well, we know just as much as we did before.
we still know that one of those...
All of a sudden! Bring back the party is reunited!
Hooray!
Oh,
hey guys!
You're
still
here!
Hello. Yeah, I thought we saw a flare and we just ran for the exit.
Well, what? It's one of these marked by the charred signs.
Map.
Oh, the map rolls a 4. It uncovers which exit sign is the correct one. It's the left.
Oh, there's only one on here.
Oh. There you go.
Finally, these maps...
Useful for something.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Upon opening the door, daylight breaks through, and they finally step out of the dark, dank forest.
I'm still a maple.
Before them, as they enter the bright area, their eyes still squinting because it's bright, they see a colossal sight, a massive bridge made of stone and held up by 1,000 trolls. It wobbles and shakes under the weight.
We only have a 2-ton weight limit.
We're only 4 of the 1,000 trolls.
We're the biggest ones. You can't see the ones in the back.
Yeah, the rest of them, they really don't contribute.
We're like ants. We can lift a lot.
Well, let us cross.
Well, how much do you weigh?
That's rude.
It's pertinent.
If you guys have 1,000, you could, like, lift us up, like...
No, that depends. We've been doing this for a while.
Is it like a crowd surfing deal? You just pass us?
Yes!
That's exactly it! How did you know?
They look a little shifty.
Hey, a little shifty.
The bot rolls a 4 on his insight, again figuring that this bridge is not what it seems.
We promise not to throw you.
We won't throw you!
My detector is going off.
We've never thrown anyone.
We're nice. We always call home.
That was like 6 lies.
Can we huddle?
Team huddle.
Team huddle.
I say we go under the bridge.
Like through the tunnel?
Well,
we dig a tunnel.
It goes over
water.
The gap of land, so we don't need to go through the. It's there's no land there already. We're just gonna. Just no, not a tunnel.
All right, let's do it, Jake. We can avoid those trolls.
I need to find a new weapon. I lost my wrench in the magical forest.
A broom of sweeping that is a fire. It vibrates, I don't know why.
I have an idea how to get rid of the trolls.
Oh, what's that?
Hey, I have... What do you guys call these things?
Hold it, Brink!
Apples!
Yeah.
Larger and larger. A lone figure, draped in cloth and hooded, shrouding their face, approaches the party with a small lip in their step.
Are you okay?
Apple?
Helps the ale.
Rolling a 3 for the traded apple, the strange figure presents them with a chest, unlocked, but closed.
Are we allowed to have that chest?
So the apple is useful, but if you want this, you need more.
More?
Rolling a 3 again, you will accept and give them a chest.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah. I was figuring you could just open it.
That works too.
Upon opening the container, they see what looks like salad tongs. But they're not normal. They're go-go gadgets. Salad tongs. Realizing what they have before them, an infinitely long extending go-go gadget salad tongs, they know what they can do.
We can do that. Yeah.
Rolling a 4, he successfully transplants the salad tongs onto his arm, removing the faulty plate.
Can you grab one of them?
I guess you can put that down.
Hump the ale.
We cut to the other half of the party drinking ale heartily while being mocked by little people.
We have to kill you now!
I'm not kidding myself.
And then all of a sudden, giant tongs come down.
What the fuck? Don't tell anyone about the ale!
We cut to the party at the top of the canyon.
Yeah!
Good job,
Smokey. What was that?
Too fast.
Man. So fucking drunk right now.
What happened down there?
Hey, watch your tail.
What happened down there, man?
Oh, they were like these creatures. They were like flying and talking at the same time and they
spoke in tongues.
I think
with tongues. Sorry.
They fell on their heads.
So can
Bag and Smokey Bot 5000 do a quick look around, noticing the creature is no longer there, but instead a note up on the ground.
This one's not in binary.
Well,
it says, "You are our only hope. Save us. For the sun will hit the earth. Use this code 1122. Left, right, A, B, A, B. Start. This will be your saving grace.
1122, left, right, start.
Signed by Tim Horton.
Anybody know the Tim Horton?
You know what? I'm going back. Fuck it.
Dude,
unfortunately, Smokey rolls a 1 and doesn't catch him. He goes hurling down towards the river. The dwarf, Eldon, flying, falling. And we will end there tonight. At the cliff end, quite literally. Alright, so before we end, someone did some art for us. You guys might have noticed in the event cover art. That was Daniel. And like I said last time, we decided to come together and get him a gift for drawing some art in the form of his oversized D20. And if you guys want to do more art for us, please do. We might give you a thing. Might being a keyword, but might's